Well, we're at 9:02. Good morning, everyone. So, welcome to another week where we continue moving forward. I've got some interesting ideas, again, interesting links, things to think about. So let's get right into this. So, you know, one of the things as I continue to evolve this and morph this, what would I like you to be thinking about, or what would I like you to be taking away from this? Well, a couple of things. And to me, this is about getting your brain thinking differently, right? We always talk about think differently, understand what the changes are. And that really, at least from my perspective, that's the main message out of these presentations and this content. So in no particular order, and I'm going to be adjusting this list over time, I think the first one is understanding what these disruptions are. I think there's a difference between looking at a news article and saying, wow, isn't that interesting, or wow, isn't that neat, to, wait a minute, there's some underlying disruptions that are going on here, and what are they, and why do I care? So I think that's kind of number one. I would say number two is, what's being impacted? This gets us back to that whole, there's an investment, there's a consumer preference, there's muscle memory that's changing, there's resistance that's being overcome. Something's happening there. And again, we're going to be reading these things a little bit differently. And I think the last one is, and then once you have that in place, start asking yourself, well, if it does impact me, what do you need to do to get ahead of these disruptions? So I think that pretty much covers the gamut, right, of what we're trying to do here. I think this is the essence of thinking differently. It's just not reading it. It's understanding it and then reacting to it. You know, one of the interesting articles that I found that kind of sets up the first two or three this week was this whole concept about disruption in of itself isn't new. And what I liked about this one, as I read through it, they've always talked about, and they use the ATM. I believe this was a snowstorm and people couldn't get to the banks. And, you know, the ATMs became the innovation, as it were, that changed this idea of going into a bank and actually dealing with a teller to working and interacting with a machine. And I think the real takeaway here is that, and I forget where it exactly was here. So let's see real quick if I can find it. Ah, here it is. You know, it says February 78 will always be remembered for a blizzard that dumped as much as 4 feet of snow, blah, 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 blah. Instead, people got their money by cashing checks at the local supermarket, but most of the supermarkets quickly ran out of money. Where there's pain, there's opportunity. And I think that becomes the missive out of this. And as we look at what's going on right now, what are the pain points, or what are the things that people are now going to have to adjust to? And from my perspective, we've already talked about contactless type technologies. We're going to see that again today. What are going to be opportunities in that space that protect people? I think that's another opportunity. So, you know, as you look at this particular one from Inc. Magazine or Inc., really think about this concept of pain, I guess. You know, what is the pain? What is the opportunity, in a sense? And I think this article gets you started, at least on that thinking. Now, the funny part to this, this is kind of part two. And part two to this, and again, these were just two different articles that I saw I'm putting together. But with a lot of these large, and this one just talks about, you know, the technology companies that are laying people off. And again, a lot of this has to do with lack of revenue, trying to maximize or, you know, keep the company going for as long as it can. I'm not so much worried about the layoff piece of this. The quote in this particular article that I liked is, again, getting back to where we've kind of seen this before, as Yogi Berra used to say, deja vu all over again. And some of today's most valuable companies, this was the quote within the article, were forged in the 2008 financial crisis, such as Airbnb, Dropbox, and Uber. And, you know, I think it was toward the end of the article here. Let's double check this. You know, but there were flickers of hope. A lot of people who were out of work could become really innovative and create really disruptive technology. Remember, it's not always about the technology itself. It's also the application of technology. So, you know, one of the things to be thinking about here, and let's put these two articles together. Number one, can you identify a pain point? Can you identify something that's either broken, something that could be fixed, something that could be done better? That's really the seeds of disruption. And then part two is putting together that business model for that. And again, you could be a technology-based solution, or you could be leveraging technology in a new way. And I think that really becomes this missive of what we're talking about for disruptive technologies. You could either be disrupted, which is kind of a sucky place to be, or you could be the one on the front end of the disruption helping to guide that disruption and make it happen. And truth be told, I think that goes, I'm going to go back here, that goes all the way back to how I started today. It's how do you get ahead of this disruption so that you are not impacted by the disruption? And I think these two articles, if you get a chance to read through them, really do encompass this this idea of look for where opportunities are. I can tell you right now, I'm talking just, you know, we're having conversations in general, looking at the way, you know, people are looking at certain technologies right now, the way people are led to implement certain technologies. Just interesting conversations. It's kind of enlightening even at the conversation level because it gets you thinking. So, you know, to give you a part two on this, I would say this is where the networking has to come in. And the networking component, I may have to add this as a net new, but a networking component really should include what are you seeing that's broken? What are you seeing that could be done better? What are you seeing that could be fixed? Because I think it changes the tenor of the networking conversation to, you know, how do you fix the current here or now? Or what does a 3 to 5 year window look like? And in that 3 to 5 year window, what are you really trying to prepare for? Remember, if all you're going to do is get a job that lasts, say, 18 months, just to pick a random, you know, year and a half time frame, well, what are you going to do 18 months from now? So again, I think having these networking conversations and talking about disruption or what are you seeing in that space that's either broken or can be enhanced or could be modified or done better, to me, those are some of the nuances of networking conversations. What the heck that was? I heard some music somewhere. Wow. It was strange. So the next piece to this was education disruption. Now, if we go back for a minute, right, we saw the COVID disruption, number one. We saw that students were sent home, number two. We saw the increase of, why am I drawing a blank? Video conferencing type solutions like Zoom and the like. Now, Zoom in of itself, and I had a conversation with someone this past week, Zoom in of itself is not new, but now it was just used in a more creative way. Well, if you put all of that together, we kind of get to this observation where if students aren't going to go to colleges or they prefer to have remote education, in this particular one, I love this paragraph. There's a recognition or disappointment across America. It's more the recognition that Zoom has uncovered how disappointing college education is. I think there's a lot of households saying, this is what we're paying for. So again, this isn't meant to be a knock on the college in so much as I'm looking at the delivery mechanism here. So this was from the Daily Wire. This particular one, again, was really talking about, and here's the quote that I grabbed from it. But again, you know, if you think about, and this one also talked about foreign students being a cash cow because they're not, you know, they pay the full tuition. There's no help that they get. So I think this is yet another disruption even at the education level. Now, we know that there's been a ton of free content that's available on YouTube and Coursera. Well, not free, but low cost on Coursera and the like that you can take advantage of. And I think that this gets us back to this theme of something was quote unquote broken. You know, you see students that pick up hundreds of thousands of dollars in debt for tuition and room and board or whatever it is. And this may be another inflection point where this gets changed. Now, where does this go? How do they? I don't know. I'm not in this space per se, but I think you get the idea. The next two were on restaurants, and it was very interesting, again, how technology is impacting them. So quick review, right? you can't get out. Restaurants are closed down. They're going to be limited in terms of how many people they can have when they open, social distancing, blah, 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 right? So this first one gets us back to, and I think this one was overseas. This was not here. This one was, where was this? This was in South Korea. So in South Korea, at Coffee Bar K in Seoul, a robo bartender has replaced a human, can make perfect cocktails in a fraction of time. And, you know, one of the things here is, whoops, sorry. The bar is encouraging customers to return, promoting its use of robots, preparing drinks in a contactless environment, right? We've seen this over the past, whatever it's been, right? As a bid to attract patrons and increase sales. Again, it's another disruptor. Now, I don't, you know, you go to a bar, sometimes depending on the bar, right, there is some form of interaction. You know, in a small bar, I don't know if this is going to impact a small bar because I think the dynamics of a small bar are different. But in a larger setting, you know, if a robot was preparing the drinks, would you really know the difference? So again, this gets us back to combining pieces of the disruption. Robotics becomes a piece. Contactless becomes a piece. Fear or preference becomes a piece. And you start putting that together, this potentially changes muscle memory, which we've talked about. And it's just another example of a space that helping companies become contactless in what they do becomes, I would think, or I'm going to take a guess, a new type of job responsibility or role in the months and years ahead. Now, the funny part to this one is part two, right? This is even better, and this is going to get us to this week's kind of, you know, assignment. So voice assistants. Now, this particular one was for, where is it? All Recipe. That's a pretty neat headline, right? All Recipe's Alexa skill. The traffic is up 67% and unique users rise 80%. Now, the two quotes that I took out of here, again, disruption, muscle memory, change of habit, all of this fits in. So the first, the inconvenience of going out for a meal, even for takeout, is leading more people to cook at home. Given that most people have a limited repertoire of dishes they cook and now lack the variety of eating frequently at restaurants, it makes sense that they would be looking to learn new recipes to prepare. So there we have the disruption, there we have the opportunity, and in this particular case, I'm sorry, what was the name of the place here? It was All Recipes. So All Recipes, I don't know when they created it, but they created an Alexa skill. We're going to cover that in a minute. But the other part to this is that we've talked about this before too, is creating a community. So much like in one of my presentations, I've talked about, you know, you can go out on the Echo and actually participate in the community about answering questions. I'm not suggesting that, you know, you run out and become chefs, in so much as this is going to prepare your thinking as to how do you use a skill, how do you leverage a community, how do you join a community, how do you participate in a community. So in this particular paragraph, which was a little later in the article, not only can the skill give you information, but people are starting to interact with each other and they're building out a community. So when we talk about skills, when we talk about networking, when we talk about being able to find an answer, when you talk about being able to engage a community to get an answer, these become important skills because these platforms are in place. It's not like they're new. The question becomes, did you take the time to figure out the platform that's closest to what you do or what you're involved with? Now, this gets a little silly, but again, it's people that are reimagining or rethinking a space. Now, in this particular one, Aldi, they put a traffic light system in. So I don't know exactly how they're doing this, but they're actually, I don't know if it's AI that's counting the number of heads or whatever it is, but they're actually using a system to allow people to enter the store when it is quote unquote safe to see. Now, this doesn't disrupt an existing job per se, but it disrupts the experience of going to a store. Now, is this going to be something that becomes prevalent? I don't know. But it just shows you that there are these different opportunities to be thinking about, or different ways of understanding, is something quote unquote broke or something in need of a fix? And this just aligns with that thinking. This is a little on the techie side for everybody. So SD-WAN, for those that don't know, SD stands for software defined, and WAN stands for wide area networking. And as more people work from home, there are certain requirements that come with that capability. And one of them is going to be bandwidth. Can you control the session? What's the performance of the session? All of those different pieces. So in this particular one, this article was just talking about, I'm sorry, I forgot to include, this was the Aldi one. This is the Aldi link for COVID-19, sorry. In this other next one, so now I think one of the key comments that I put it here. So two things. One, how they perceive the home is going to be one. There's a line in here about Comcast is saying that they're going to have an office in the box, I think. Where is it? I thought a little quick here. Right here, branch in the box. So this is Comcast. Techs already have to enable branch in the box solutions for home offices. So again, I think another service offering comes out of this. So that's a capability. That's number one. I think number two, the other thing to understand, and we talked about it, I think, last week, is how quickly these things have gotten sped up. It was either last week or the week before. So this whole requirement now of having the home be yet another segment of an enterprise network or a component of an enterprise network is really what this is about. So if you're in networking technology, this is yet another capability or skill that you're going to need. Again, I'm still, I've been crazy busy on a couple of things, but what I did for this one is just underlined with all those articles that we talked about today. Here are the types of skills that bubbled out just on these, whatever it was, six or seven articles. So we've already seen digital assistants, and I've said this numerous times over the years. If you don't have a digital assistant, get one. I don't care which one you get, just get one. Learn about how you get skills, learn how you talk to it. Understanding how a digital assistant works is going to be important in the months and years ahead. Creativity, you know, they always talk about this skill of being creative or critical thinking. As you look through some of these news articles, start thinking about how creativity played a role. We saw contactless technologies again. We see distance learning, right? That was the whole education part, and it gets us back to Zoom and video conferencing, and networks and robotics, right? So these were the types of skills. I'm telling you that all of these are applicable to you, but these are the types of skills that were just scattered across those articles. So again, getting back to where we started, look at the opportunity. What does it disrupt? Does it disrupt you? What skills do you need to have? That's the missive. So what can you do for your 30-minute daily? Here's an idea. Experiment with an Alexa skill. Now, I've got two different links here. So again, for those that don't know, I just happen to have one. It's not even plugged in. So, you know, on your Alexa, right? I have an Alexa here, but I got a Google Home sitting over here as well. So, you know, the first thing you do is you hook this up, you get to talk to it, yay, right? The next thing that you can do, especially on the Alexa, is there is a series of skills out on Amazon.com, and I just happen to have it up here, which is, I'm sorry, right there, there's a little delay here. So here is a skill. Basically, you can, you know, if you're logged in, you sign in and you click to enable it, and it becomes free. And usually there's a little description about what does it do and how does it work. Now, in this particular case, oh, come on, silly. So All Foods actually has a page on their site that actually talks about enabling it and things for you to try. So it's going to give you actual commands that you can ask. Now, usually, and again, it depends on the skill, some will have examples on the Alexa page or the Amazon Alexa page, as to how do you invoke the skill or how do you talk to the skill. And some companies or some sites may actually have a site dedicated to talking about how, you know, other ways to use the skill. And I'm sure if you do a Google search, you can find a couple as well. And then the other piece to this is if you just go to allrecipes.com, which I did not put up, allrecipes.com, you know, this is where you can create your profile and join the community. So again, if you're not familiar with doing that, you know, it's just a real quick overview, right? There's a skill, go join the skill. You don't have to join the community, but if you wanted to join the community, let's just say there's some, you know, work-related thing, this just becomes a piece of muscle memory, as I like to call it, of I've got a skill, let me go find the community, blah, 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 blah. So, yeah, I don't know where that loud music came from. Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. I don't know where that came from. I got to go. I don't know if it was a site that did something in one of my tabs, but outside of that, that's what I had for this week. It was a little shortened version this week, but that's kind of where my thinking's going. Let me see something here. What else did I have? All right, the ways, right, obviously, to connect. I did a presentation yesterday at, Friday, at a PSG of Mercer. So I don't know if anyone had a chance to see that. I'll be putting that up on my YouTube channel at some point in time. David Chuckman sent me the link. I just didn't have the opportunity to trim it and upload it and whatever. Still working on a couple other odds and ends. A personal commercial is still in flight. I can't wait to share that with you, but I haven't. This week was kind of hashing out what the script or what the message needs to be. If I get a chance, I'll record it this week. It will be recorded this week. I don't know if it'll be released this week. I have to get some feedback on what I'm doing with it. But that's pretty much what I had. Again, to me, I've been really embracing disruption. I've been having a couple conversations with people that we're doing some basic analysis. We have some personal beliefs around how do I say this? What people might be conditioned to do versus I'll share one. You know, we're having a conversation about the cloud as an example, and you'll hear people talk about the cloud and they're going to quote unquote move to the cloud. Well, you know, is that really what the value proposition is? Because there's a whole ton of other things to be thinking about in terms of business processes, application rationalization, data. There's a number of pieces that you get a chance to re-examine what you're doing when you get out there. And when you start looking at the space and you think about other people and what they're doing, or how they advise people to get somewhere, this is the nature of the conversation we're having. And again, we're still in ideation phase, but it's an interesting conversation nonetheless. And Dolce, thank you for the thank you for the kind words. It usually goes well. And that was actually the first presentation. I want to talk about change. That was actually the first time I had to take a presentation and change it mid-year. It's rare. I don't think I've ever had to do, I mean, yeah, maybe I changed the date and, you know, maybe there's one new piece of information I get, but I usually don't touch the presentations. They pretty much sit on their own for an entire year. And this one has just, I was really surprised. Well, not surprised, but, it was interesting to watch how quickly the changes happened this year and you know, how it impacted the presentation. So, and it seemed to went well. The feedback was good. You know, it's always about thinking differently, which is, you know, what I'm about. So that's pretty much it. I didn't have much more than that. Any questions, any thoughts? I see you guys have been quiet today. I hope you're enjoying this. I hope you're enjoying this. It's a labor of love at this point. But yes, Nancy, these are unprecedented times, most definitely. I can't, you know, but it also gets back to, you know, you control what you can control. And but so, yeah, this is a time, you know, this is a time to educate yourself. This is a time to this is a time to reskill. You know, we saw the labor report. I take government numbers sometimes for what they're worth. But, you know, it will be interesting to see what happens when this COVID thing does dissipate. You know, they're starting to open up the various states. I had actually talked to a few recruiters this week where they all believe that starting in the July timeframe that things are going to start opening up. So, you know, food for thought. There's change coming. There's opportunity coming, and we all want to be part of it. So, so I'm hoping that this advice and these the review of these links is helpful. And that's pretty much what I got for you guys this week. So, kind of give it a one last shot here. Any final questions? Any thoughts? Anything good? Perfect. So thanks for stopping by. If I get a chance today or tomorrow, I'm going to put last week's and this week's up on my YouTube page. And that's pretty much it. So enjoy your Sunday. Enjoy your week. And we will do it again next week. Take it easy, everyone. Bye.